Concealment is made up of three key principles: grip tuck, slide tuck, and body placement paired with clothing drape. In this video, we're going to be talking about each of those principles, what they mean, and how to apply them. Really quickly, I do want to just establish why concealment is a challenge for us in the first place, and that is that we're all made up of organic shapes and curves and peaks and valleys, and that poses a major challenge for us when we try to take an object that is an inorganic shape with harsh corners and we try to place it on our organically shaped body and make it disappear. Keep this in mind as we discuss the science behind making inorganic shapes disappear on organic shapes. Typically, the grip of the gun poses the biggest challenge when it comes to concealment. If we don't take intentional steps to cause the grip of the gun to make contact with our body, then it will naturally poke out and cause noticeable printing. This is why grip tuck is a key component to concealment. We achieve grip tuck by using concealment features like wings and wedges and pairing those with pressure from a belt or an enigma. Without pressure, neither of those features will cause meaningful grip tuck. The next most likely portion of the gun to cause printing is the top of the slide. If the top of our gun is tipping out and away from our body, then the top of the slide, our rear sight, or even our optic can be seen through our clothing. This concealment problem is also solved by using concealment features like wings and wedges. Angled wings like the dark wing and the mod wing with the E-mod wing inserts interact with pressure and cause the top of the gun to tip slightly closer to the body than the bottom portion of the gun, acting like a fulcrum. Although these angled wings can create enough slide tuck for some people, many people will also need the help of a wedge to tuck the slide of the gun in closer to the body. To learn more about wedges and how to use them, you'll want to watch our video dedicated to that topic. Earlier, we talked about how we're all made up of organic shapes with curves and peaks and valleys, and this is why it's really important that we consider where we're placing our gun on our body. For example, if we were to place the gun in the center of this model's stomach, which would be considered a peak, then she would continue to have issues with printing, regardless of how well she has taken advantage of grip tuck and slide tuck. But when we move the gun off of her peak into a valley and take advantage of grip tuck and slide tuck, she's able to achieve her desired level of concealment by placing her gun in her concealment sweet spot. Make sure to keep an eye out for future videos on this topic, and if you're looking for more resources, don't forget to check out our YouTube channel, our website, and our Facebook group.